Hello everyone, and welcome to this specific talk about the customer voice on marketplaces and what you can learn from it. First, let me quickly introduce our three amazing speakers. Georg Aas from the software company Kaspersky, welcome. Maybe you can make a little tick so the audience, yeah, perfect. Martin Fehrmann from Marketplace Otto, one of the big players in German e-commerce. And Christian Driehaus from Gominga, the review management company. Thank you. And I'm Adrian from Lengo, and I will moderate this talk. So let's get straight to the point. No time to lose. Today, we know two things. First, online reviews are increasingly important for shoppers. Recently, I saw again in a study that 88% of consumers read reviews before purchase. That's huge. Not to mention that algorithms take reviews into account. Second, marketplaces are growing like mad, even faster than e-commerce in a whole. The marketplace business is today far more than just Amazon and eBay. I mean, there are now many generalists, I mean, such as Otto in Germany, or more specialized marketplaces like Zalando, for example, for the fashion sector. So taking these trends into account, what is actually going on with reviews and ratings on marketplaces? I mean, how can they help to drive the business? That's the real question. So let's directly start with a question for Martin to have the view from the marketplace side. How important, Martin, are reviews and ratings for you? And how do you get customers actually to write a review on Otto?
Yeah, a pretty good question. You already mentioned it. We are a growing platform with an increasing number of products, and reviews are coming more and more into our auto focus. What I must mention, and it's pretty nice to know, that we currently only have reviews on the product detail page that are actually related to the product itself. We don't get ratings on how good the delivery was or the customer service itself was. But yes, we think that the product reviews are important as it helps the customers in an advisory way during the decision-making process. And we know that from different UX tests, but what we cannot analyze now is the monetary impact of ratings yet.
Okay. So reviews are pretty important for you. Maybe Georg, I would also like to have the brand's view. I mean, what is Kaspersky's experience on selling on marketplaces, and how important is customer engagement on marketplaces for you? And do you respond to reviews and product questions on these platforms?
Yeah, many questions from your side. Yes, absolutely. So let's start with marketplaces in general. They are really important for us. We see a huge trend from switching from tangible, so physical products, to digital products. So that's why ESDs and downloads on marketplaces are getting more and more important. So this means we have a dedicated strategy for marketplaces, how we want to work with them, how we want to act with them for the next years. And I think this is really important for brands and vendors in general. And we see different strategies also needed in different countries and cultures, because the customers and users are behaving, the behavior is different all over there. An easy example is with test awards. Yeah, in Germany, test awards really are really important. So my mom is always buying products with a good test award or results. In other markets in Europe, we don't see this behavior. So we have to think about how we communicate to the customers in the different markets and on different marketplaces to to meet their expectations and their behavior. And that's why it is really important to differentiate in different countries. And also with ratings, so the impact of ratings is definitely high from our perspective. And that's why we are working with ratings and analyzing this for a really long time.
Okay. And really, do you respond to reviews and product questions specifically? Do you try to learn from ratings and reviews? How does it work?
Absolutely, yes. So, and it's not just about reviews, it's also about questions. As you know, many marketplaces and platforms, they also have a community where the customers are asking questions about the products. And this is, I always compared with in the past, yeah, you went to a retail store, you met an expert, you asked them questions and so on. And now the world is changing to a more digital world. This automatically means we have to give the customers the same feedback, the same experience, and that's why it is important to reply to such questions and also to ratings. And we are doing this for a really long time, so we started around about 2014 to work really hard and on this area. So this means we started working with an agency, with a partner on this side to analyze the reviews. What are the questions from the customers? What are their needs? And we are responding to them. And this is really important from our perspective, because we this influence also the buying decision of the customer from our perspective. Of course, what we learned at the university, for example, in the marketing part, that one happy customer influence eight others, and in a digital world, this impact is much higher. So this means if we reply to the customers to questions and on a review level, this will impact more and more customers, and this will definitely increase buying decision from all customers, and not even on one platform, also on other platforms, we see an impact. And that's why it's definitely important to analyze the reviews and to reply to the customers.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Actually, you are using the Gominga tool for review management, Georg. So that's really interesting to have this exchange with Christian and Georg today. I will come back later to this one, because you mentioned also positive reviews and the impact on sales numbers. For Martin, another question on this specific topic. Are there big performance differences between products that have many positive reviews and those that have none? Maybe also take in account the price, because actually, even if a product has many negative reviews but a very good price, you know, and mm-hmm. you have like the same product but with very good ratings but the price is much higher, still, yeah, is there a big difference between them, or is at the end the price the most important? I don't know mm-hmm. if you have some experience on that level.
We have some basic experience with this, but at Otto we deal a bit more, but we deal very intensively with how strong the influence of individual features and information on the product itself are, and what affects the purchase possibility. That means we are not focusing that much on the rating itself, because we don't have so many same products on our platform yet, because our marketplace just started last year. That means we are not having like this this many products with the same from the same brand and same price. But we know from studies that price has a significantly higher influence than product ratings. But however, we believe that when deciding between similar products with almost identical conditions, just like price, shopping cost, delivery time, the product review can be the decisive factor.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's come back to the topic review management and how Georg is managing reviews actually with the help of Gominga. Maybe Christian, from your client base, what are typical other use cases of review management? Of course, you can talk about Georg, but do you have other experiences and what's your opinion?
Yes, I mean Georg mentioned a few points. In general, we have two different sides. Well, I mean, first of all, what Martin said, we always have the customer view. Yeah, so we know that customers read reviews, that they take them into account during their purchase decision-making process. But for us, the important question is really, what do companies do with those reviews? What do companies do with those questions? And there we have the two sides. The one side is really all about analytics. So what do you as a company do with all that customer feedback? Yeah, do you monitor that? Do you analyze it? Do you get the insights? Yeah, do you understand what the strengths and weaknesses of your products and services are? So this is one big part of our business and how we help our clients. And we have many clients, not only Kaspersky, but others like Samsung, like LG, like Gardena, in all different industries, not only consumer electronics, but also DIY, sporting goods, etc. And some of them really use our review analytics modules to almost replace traditional market research because they say, okay, at any time, anywhere in the world, at a click of a button, they can really understand the market sentiment. They can really understand what do users, what do the actual consumers out there think about their products and services. So that's one really big area. Which we believe is it's still a big opportunity for many companies because they don't embrace it yet. And I mean, it's in a way, it's market research for free because it's out there, the data is out there. You simply have to analyze it and make use of it. And the second part, I mean, you asked the questions previously, do you respond? That's in our view also a big opportunity in terms of customer engagement. I believe in today's world, in today's digital world, the consumer, they don't differentiate the channels anymore. Yeah, if a company actively manages social media accounts like Facebook and they interact with users on Facebook, they post something, they respond something on Facebook, for example, the company should do obviously the same thing on marketplaces, on Amazon, on Google, on Otto, if it is possible in the future. Yeah, because they didn't differentiate the channels. They see the brand and they only see the brand. I mean, they don't differentiate if the product is sold by a brand or by a third-party seller. It's always the brand that is at stake. Hence, we believe responding to reviews, responding to those questions is key.
Yes, that's really interesting because you're saying basically that a good review management can replace market research or kind of free market research. I think that's a really important aspect. And also that you're saying that, of course, brands, companies, retailers, they know that on social media they need to respond to questions and so on. But I think they might forget a little bit also the marketplace side that there are also reviews and questions, and we also need to respond there. So
Maybe
that's a good
just to add to both of those statements. I mean, the first one about the research part, especially in North America, there are a lot of studies, academic studies also that underline, especially today with modern AI, you can really analyze and really dig deep and get those insights. Yeah, so I mean, we don't say that it will replace traditional market research for 100%, but it's coming pretty close and it's a great addition to that. And as you say, for comparing to social media, if you look at the traffic on Amazon, on Google, on Otto, on Walmart, on all those big marketplaces, if you really compare the traffic, today it's there's like no reason why you should not respond and actively manage reviews and product questions on those big platforms. Yeah, because I mean, yes, Facebook and Twitter and all those, there is obviously millions of users, but the same applies to Amazon, Google, and all those big ones in the marketplace arena.
Maybe another thing, because in my introduction I said that algorithms are taking into account reviews. Maybe for you, Martin, and also for you, Georg, for the marketplace side, do you take into account, for example, negative reviews in the search rating results, Martin? And then for Georg, how are many negative reviews handled? Yeah, that would be interesting to know.
Should I start? Yeah, I will start.
Yeah.
At Otto, in general, product ratings don't have any influence on the visibility of the product in the shop. That means we don't hide bad rated products, but we have like a constantly check behind or in the system that will show bad ratings. Bad ratings means 1 or 2 star ratings, but just to identify possible and critical product defects. Just for example, if there's a chair that has constantly 1 or 2 stars and the customer said it's kind of broken, so we can prevent some accidents. And then if there's a case like this, we pass them to the category managers, to the manufacturers, or to the marketplace sellers. On our side, authenticity, credibility of the product reviews on the Otto platform is our highest concern. That it also includes the negative reviews that helps our customers to form a differentiated picture of the product itself, so we're not hiding anything. And for this reason, we only influence product ratings in an absolutely exceptional cases.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And you, Georg, negative reviews, how do you manage them? Or have you negative reviews? Because, I mean, maybe you don't have any, so I don't know.
So I would say everyone has at the end negative reviews, because we all know that customers, if they are not happy, they will find a way to communicate, and for sure reviews are a new way of communication for the customers. Where can they why they are not happy about the product? And that's why this reviews and analysis and talking and replying to the customers is so important, because if a customer is unhappy about the delivery, for example, so as this doesn't belong to the marketplace or to the product and to the brand, and that's why it is important to reply to such reviews and to ask the customer, okay, what is the issue, how can we help you, is there a way how we can solve the situation, and so on. That's really important. If we take a look at the last years, since we started doing this, we see 8% less negative reviews. So this means talking to the customers and replying to such questions and reviews means you automatically get less negative reviews on one hand, and on the other hand we get 10 times more positive reviews. So the impact is dramatically high, and that's why I definitely recommend to think about and to have a strategy behind your marketplaces and your reviews from a brand perspective.
Maybe because we were talking about market research, and can you confirm what Christian said? I mean, are you using reviews and ratings for market search? I mean, maybe you have some insights here.
So it's a question to me, I guess. Yes. So. So yes, Christian also mentioned a buzzword, sentiment, he said. This means with Gominga we started a sentiment analysis, for example. So I'm sure Christian can explain it a little bit better afterwards if someone is interested in. But in other words, this means we are analyzing the keyword ratings on a brand perspective and on a product perspective or level at the end. And based on this analysis, we know how the customers are thinking, acting, and replying to our brand, which is on one hand important for marketing activities, sales activities, and on the other hand, On a product level, we can share this information with R&D, with product development, so that they know from a market perspective, from a local perspective, how the users are thinking, what are their needs, and so you can develop and increase your products in the long term. So this is definitely really important.
Okay, interesting. Christian, because you're kind of the big expert on the level reviews, ratings, I mean, you have many different brands using your review management tool. Maybe you have some recommendations, trends, or do's and don'ts you observe. Maybe you can share them. That would be great.
Sure. Let's start with a few general recommendations. I mean, first of all, it's all about big data today. And as I said previously, make use of that big data. And if you just think about multiplying the number of ratings, reviews, and questions you as a brand have across those different marketplaces, across the different countries that you are active in, that really is big data. So make use of that. Then obviously value the voice of the customer, show that you respect the feedback, show that you value it and respond and engage and see it as an opportunity. I mean, I know a few years ago, people were reluctant and hesitant at what is review management all about and why should I do it. I really see it as an opportunity. I see it as an opportunity to get the insights, to understand what users think about your products and services and take the opportunity to engage and to respond. I think that's one advice or one recommendation I can always give. In terms of trends, what we see interestingly in the past, let's say 12, 18 months is, yes, of course, the big marketplaces, and I mean, Amazon worldwide is obviously, at least in the world that we think of, the largest players, but also the other ones. We see the trend that Amazon is still number one across all industries, but other marketplaces have become more important. Brands also want to reduce risks, obviously. So, I mean, Otto or in France, Fnac or Mano Mano or all those other ones have become more important. And also brand web shops. So direct to consumer, that trend we see that our clients like Samsung and others, they have own brand web shops and they also use reviews as a trust factor. So this is another trend that we see. Yeah? It's one big marketplace. Then there's other marketplaces that have caught up in the past year or two across different industries. Yeah, there's obviously always industry champions. Then direct to consumer trend with own brand web shop. And last but not least, the other trend that we see is mobile app reviews. Yeah, because more and more devices that traditionally were sold via marketplaces as a hardware device, they are now managed via mobile apps. So that combination is important to understand that also mobile app reviews are obviously important because, I mean, if it is about your home appliances, your gardening, your lawnmower, they're all roboters nowadays. They're all being managed and steered by mobile apps. So that's the last thing in terms of trends that we see. Yeah, it's marketplaces, it's brand web shops, and it's mobile app reviews.
Okay. Yeah, so far, thank you a lot for all the insights and strategy sharing. There might be one topic we didn't cover because we are running out of time. It's the unfair and fake review topic. I know that Christian is passionate about it. So really feel free to catch up with him during Lengo Day. To have a chat about it. I mean, if it's a topic that interests you, because I think he might be delighted to talk about it. So we have seen that, I mean, a good and intelligent review management on marketplaces, I think, can help drive and grow the business, but also to better understand the customer and also to make free marketing research. So some great takeaways here. Thank you again, really, for everyone, for your participation. And enjoy Lengo Day. Thank you. Thank you a lot.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.